to Guarneri, and you know where I am, at my office at Pacific Pearl La Jolla. It's really exciting to me to be in springtime, because spring is a time of rebirth. Spring is a time of life. Spring is a time of joy. And this is actually my favorite time of the year. The good news is in San Diego, our COVID-19 numbers are really down and our hospitalizations are down, but they are not zero, which means that if we do not get vaccinated and we do not wear our face mask, we run the risk of having another surge and another spike in our county. And we are currently seeing this in other places in the country, like Michigan right now. Now, we have the impact of COVID right here, but we also have the opportunity to do things that keep us healthy. And that includes wearing our face masks, getting our vaccine. I still want everyone to maintain social distancing. And for those of you who are members of Pacific Pearl, and you're afraid to get vaccinated, or you're concerned about vaccine side effects, I really want you to call and talk to me. I want to talk to you, and I know about two of you. Everyone else, I believe, has been vaccinated, especially because we made most of the arrangements. COVID is affecting life as we know it, and many of you saw our appeal in our newsletter for our children's school in southern India. It has been a devastating time for certain regions of the world, not only with rampant COVID, but job loss, unemployment, and in many levels, I feel that those of you watching this video right now, we are truly blessed. Truly blessed, and I mean that. So the World Health Organization is reminding us that tomorrow is Earth Day, April 22nd. I believe this is our 51st Earth Day, and I can remember years ago wearing Earth shoes, which I had got my first pair on Earth Day. What's important about this? We have learned from Dr. Ramanathan from the Scripps Oceanographic, and from all the work we did with our Vatican program on human health and planet health, that we have a very small window to get a handle on what's going on our planet. We now know beyond a shadow of a doubt that climate change is impacting human health. We know we have 7 million deaths a year from air pollution. We know we have diseases that I never learned about in medical school, like West Nile and chikungunya and dengue. We know that we have an increase in severe weather changes. We just saw a series of tornadoes in the American Southeast. We have seen fires in the Amazon and fires in California. We know that we have huge mental health issues as a result of homes lost, businesses lost, and so on. This is real. This is not a political statement. Climate change is real, and we all need to chip in a bit, a little, or a lot to make a difference. And I hope that you're with me on this. You know, in the Lancet article, the first big article on climate change, the authors concluded that this is the greatest threat we have in the 21st century. But it is also our greatest opportunity. And this opportunity we need to take together. So check out the World Health Organization's website, and you can read about this for yourself. For me, I love my little acronyms, so this is one that I put together for you. It's WAKE UP. And we have to wake up in time, because I'm afraid around this area we're still sleepwalking. So the W in wake up is a reminder for you to walk. I need you to walk and to stop driving. Even if you have an electric car, I want you to walk. It's good for your heart and it's good for the planet. I need you to take action. I need you to do something. I don't care what it is. I need you to either compost or to start a garden or to go and volunteer in a permaculture industry. I need you to take some sort of action and stop using plastic. That would be a first and big one. Get rid of the plastic bags, the plastic bottles. Make a commitment to turn off the lights, use less water. These are things we can all do. The third is we really need to, the K in wake up is to keep the planet in mind and keep our health in mind and to minimize the waste. We have way too much waste, whether it's excess packaging that we don't need, buying things that we don't need. Please try to minimize the waste and take a look at what that means in your life. The E in wake up, you know what this is, eat vegetarian. I need you to eat a plant-based diet. It's good for your heart, it's good for the planet. So the more you can say, I'm gonna have meatless Mondays, meatless Wednesdays, meatless Fridays, I'm gonna eat my vegetables, my legumes, and my beans, that's good news for the planet because that decreases greenhouse gas effects. The U in wake up is I'm urging you to get on the case of your political leaders to really get us back into the Paris Climate Change Accord and to really do things that we need to do to have renewable energy and to really limit our carbon footprint. And we do a good job here in California, but we need to keep pushing it. And the last is the P in wake up. The P is for planting. You can plant your own garden, you can have your own herb garden right on your counter, or you can get on the computer when you hang up this video and start to plant some trees. There are beautiful tree planting programs right here all over the United States. There are tree planting programs in Israel, which are extraordinary. There are tree planting programs that I've been involved in southern India. And in fact, in the last 3 days, we planted 20,000 trees in Tamil Nadu, India. Now, planting trees changes the whole environment. It stimulates rain when it's needed. Trees produce oxygen. Trees sequester carbon dioxide, and they are our biggest allies. So we need to plant more trees and spend more time in nature. Now, my spiritual teacher has always said that the divine is in nature and nature is in the divine. And I really believe that Mother Earth is here to support us, but she's screaming for our help. And her voice is coming in fire, it's coming in illness, it's coming in air pollution, it's coming in tornadoes, it's coming in heat waves. And we need to pay attention, just like we need to pay attention to why we have COVID-19, we need to pay attention to the health of our planet, and we can all do this together. Have a great Earth Day. Bye, pearls.